morning students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good and well. Be seeing the online teaching and be benefited children, don't waste your time. Last week we started economics unit 1 about production, and we saw some of the learning objectives and introduction. Then I gave meaning of the objectives and some of the types of utility. And below the utility, we saw form utility, place utility and time utility. And then we saw about the types of production, primary production. Before the types, we saw three types, that is primary production, secondary and tertiary or service production. And in detail, we learned about all these three types of production. And then we saw the factors of production. Below the factors, we saw two different factors, primary factors and derived factors. And then factors of production are divided into land, labor, capital and organization. And then about in detail we learn about the land and characteristics of land. Below the characteristic, we saw land is a free gift of nature. And second, we learned about the land is fixed in supply. Then we learned about land is imperishable. And then land is a primary factor of production. Then we saw land is a immovable. And land has some original indestructible powers. Then land differs in fertility. And then today we are going to learn about labor. I think previous class you all understood clearly the topics, and in detail I taught you with the pictures. I believe that you all understood. This today's class we are going to learn about the labor and characteristic of labor, division of labor and merits, demerits of labor, capital, forms of capital, then some characteristics of capital and entrepreneur, and then characteristic of the entrepreneur, and then we are going to wind up with the summary. Now let's see what is labor. Labor is a human input into the production process. Alfred Marshall defines labor as the use of body or mind, partly or wholly, with a view to secure an income apart from the pleasure derived from the work. Who is the father of economics, children? Adam Smith is a father of the economics, and his economics is wealth economics. He wrote two classic works, that is The Theory of Moral Sentiments, then an inquiry into the nature and causes of the wealth of nations. Okay, who is the father of economics? Adam Smith. Below that we are going to see about some of the characteristic of labor. Labor is more perishable than other factors of production. It means labor cannot be stored. The labor of an unemployed worker is lost forever. For that day when he does not work, labor can neither be postponed nor accumulated for the next day. It will perish once time is lost. It is lost forever. See children, we have different types of labors, work. That is, we have the physical work, and then we can see the mind work of the labor, and then we have the machinery, machine work, and then we have the physical. The input of the work is physical, or this the works done. What are the next we see about the labor is an active factor of production. neither land nor capital can yield much without labor. Labor is not homogeneous. Skill and dexterity vary from person to person. Yes, labor cannot be separated from the laborer. Labor is mobile. Man moves from one place to another, from a low paid occupation to a high paid occupation. Individual labor has only limited bargaining power. He cannot fight with his employer for a rise in wages or improvement in workplace conditions. However, when workers combine to form trade unions, the bargaining power of labor increases. Yes, children, these are the some of the characteristics of the labor. Now we are going to see the division of labor. The concept of division of labor was introduced by the Adam Smith in his book An Enquiry into the Nature and Causes of Wealth of Nature. Division of labor means dividing the process of production into distinct and several component process and assigning each component in the hands of a labor or a set of laborers who are specialized in that particular process. Okay, children, for example, for the car manufacturing unit, the ability of the laborer is divided. So he is able to do this work, that is car manufacturing unit. Next, we have bike manufacturing unit. These are the divisions, that is according to their ability, the work is divided and given. For example, a tailor stitches a shirt in full. In the case of garment exporters, cutting of cloth, stitching of hands, body, collars, holes for buttons, stitching of buttons, etc., are done independently by different workers. Okay, each part of this garment, the tailoring, is divided and given to the laborers. Therefore, they are combining the parts into a whole shirt. Now we'll see some of the merits and demerits of this labor. What are the merits of this labor, children? It improves efficiency of labor when labor repeats doing the same task. Facilities of the use of machinery in production, resulting in inventions. Example, motors, elegraphic codes. Time and materials are put to the best and most efficient use. Yes, here are the 3 points, merits of the division of labor. Now we will see the demerits of division of labor. Repetition of the same task makes labor to feel that the work is monotonous and stale. It kills the humanity in him. Narrow specialization reduces the possibility of labor to find alternative avenues of the employment. This results in increased unemployment. Then reduce the growth of handicrafts, and the worker loses the satisfaction of having made a commodity in full. Yes, these are some of the merits and demerits of the labor. Oh, children, under labor we saw the characteristics of labor. It is divided into machinery work, physical work, mind work, and we saw some of the divisions of labor, this division of labor is according to their ability. The work is divided and given to them. If they know about the car, they are given car manufacturing unit. Then they know about the bike, they are given the bike manufacturing unit. And some examples I told you about the stitching of a shirt. A tailor, how he stitches, he cuts into different parts and then he joins and make it as a whole. And some of the merits and demerits of labor we saw. Now we are going to see what is capital. Capital is a man-made physical goods used in produce other goods and services. In the ordinary language, capital means money. Okay, it is what is the other name for this capital? It is ordinary language, or capital means it is a money. Capital is can be used as in office, in machinery. Then before that capital, we have the forms of capital. What is the what are the forms of capital? Physical capital or material resources. Example, machinery, tools, buildings. And then we have money capital or monetary resources. Example, bank deposits, shares and security, etc. Human capital or human resources. Example, investments in education, training and health. Okay, so children, forms of capital, we have factory, we have machinery, and then office. These under this is they have, so building comes under the machinery, factory, office. All these are the forms of the capital. Then we are going to see some of the characteristics of the capital. What is the characteristics of capital? Capital is a passive factor of production. Capital is man-made. Capital is not an indispensable factor of production. Capital has the highest mobility. Capital is a productive. Okay, children, capital involves present sacrifice to get future benefits. Now we'll see what is entrepreneur. An entrepreneur is a person who combines the different factors of production, that is land, labor and capital, in the right proportion and initiates the process of production, and also bears the risk involved in it. The entrepreneur is also called organizer. In modern times, an entrepreneur is called the changing agent of the society. What is the other name for an entrepreneur? Changing agent of the society. He is not only responsible for production, the socially desirable output, but also the increase the social welfare. Now we'll see the characteristics of entrepreneur. What are the characteristics of entrepreneur? Identifying profitable investable opportunities, deciding the location of the production unit, making innovations, deciding the reward payment, taking risk and facing uncertainties. This is a very important characteristic of entrepreneur. You have to know how what is the characteristic of the entrepreneur. Okay, children, today we learned about labor. We learnt about labor and characteristic of labor, and then we saw what all the different types, mind work, then machinery work, then we saw physical work, and then we saw the division of labor. below division of labor, two types, that is car manufacturing and bike manufacturing. And then we saw some of the merits and demerits of the labor. Then we saw about the capital. What is capital? What will come under the capital? What are that? Office, machine. Then forms of capital. Before that we saw forms of capital. In that we saw office, the machinery, and then factory. Then we saw the characteristics of capital, and then we saw some of the entrepreneur and some of the characteristics of the entrepreneur. Now we'll see the summary of this lesson. Production is a process of combining various material inputs and immaterial inputs in order to make something for consumption. Utility means want, satisfying power of a product. Utilities are in the nature or of form utility, time utility, and place utility. There are three types of production: primary, secondary, and tertiary or service production. Inputs are called factors of production. Factors of production are, what are they? Land, labor, capital, and organization. The concept division of labor was introduced by the father of economics. Who is he? Adam Smith. In his book, An Inquiry into the Nature and Causes of Wealth of Nations. These are some of the summary of this lesson, production. Children, I am very happy that you wrote the test, and I received only few children submitting your test. I am happy about the children who is honest doing their test and assignment. I appreciate. I want each and every one of you to follow the instruction of the teacher and do the assignment and submit, and also the test what I am giving, you should attend all the tests what I am giving. Okay student, here some of the hard words: production, characteristics, conception, identified, contributes, satisfying, commodity, manufacturing, intermediate, and then organization. These are the some of the hard words. Children, I told you how to write the notes. First you have to write only the hard words and short answers, that's all. Till now what all I have taught, what all I have sent, please copy the notes with good handwriting. I will ask you to show the notes within 4-5 days. Be ready for and write the notes. Thank you students.